Strategically located where Wales meets Shropshire and Herefordshire, the 11th century Ludlow Castle played a significant role in many conflicts, including the Wars of the Roses and the English Civil War. It was home to several printers of Wales, so Ludlow itself has for centuries been a flourishing market town, today boasting over 500 listed buildings, many from its prosperous Georgian period. Just a few miles outside the town, clustered together in a self-contained business park, four relatively new antique dealers have set up shop.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm Stacey.
Stacey. Drew.
Nice to meet you, Drew.
How are you doing?
Nice to meet you, T.
Right, can we have a look around?
Feel free.
Drawing on years of expertise, not only of artifacts, but also local history, it takes just seconds for Drew to home in.
This is nice.
Yes. Wellington knot. I bought it off a local gentleman.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's come out of Lemstraw, Ludlow, hasn't
Ludlow,
it?
Off a house, a Georgian house.
Wow. There's everything in here, from snooker cues to Tiffany lamps to models of boats to kettles. And, lo and behold, amongst all of this stuff is a fantastic door knocker. That garland stroke sort of cuff sort of motif also at the back, they've always rusted away or been nailed to the door or been lost. Never, ever seen one in such beautiful condition.
The characteristic design of this cast iron door knocker first appeared in London in 1814, after the Duke of Wellington's victory over Spain. Wellington's hand grasps the baton of Field Marshal. With the royal seal at Ludlow, patriotic symbols of this kind may have been a natural choice for the town's wealthy inhabitants to adorn their front doors. This unusually complete example could be worth around £300.
What have you got in it?
150.
What will you do for that?
I can do 100.
Really?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yes.
That's very good of you. I'll take it.
Yep, brilliant.
Like that. Well, look, thank you. We're going to carry on having a wander around all the other guys, and we'll come back and sort everything out with you later.
Yep.
Is that all right?
Brilliant.
Marvellous. Thank you.
See you in a bit.
See you later.
Next door, Alan Pomfret's specialist business has only been open for a matter of days.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Not too bad, Drew.
Drew,
not too
nice
bad.
To meet you.
I'm Alan.
Right.
Hello, T.
All right, how are we doing?
You're very neat. I've only been open 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
2 weeks is my second week of being open.
So how did you get into doing this, then?
I'm ex-military. I got into buying, collecting military for myself.
Yeah.
And then decided I was going to make a living out of it.
So the military stuff, you can tell me something, because I've just spotted something which I think I know what it is. It's the lamp.
Yes. It's either a prisoner of war or a convalescent piece.
Yeah.
It's a World War II battle dress. It's all oak carved. It's quite nice.
As soon as I walk in, I'm drawn to one thing in particular. I've always known it as convalescence art. So it's art carried out as therapy for people wounded, long-term wounded, and they are that thing which crosses a few boundaries in the antiques world as well. It's militaria, it's folk art, it's lighting, it's all of those things. I don't want the helmet.
But that can come off.
That can come off. It's absolutely lovely, isn't it?
It is.
105 on it, what can you do? I love it.
I could do 80.
Are you sure you're making money?
I'm making money at 80 on it.
Well, I'm going to buy them. Oh, yeah, that's brilliant. Lovely. Obviously, there is, you know, an emotion attached to anything from the Great Wars. It has that as well. But as a piece of art, right, it has that naivety to it that you only get with untrained artists, right? And I love that. There was something out here when we walked up. It's this carpet you've got here. Can we get it down from there?
Sure, I can get it down somehow. Sure? Just bear with me. Get that side. Right.
That's it.
Right, everybody?
Yeah.
Okay. Right.
Everybody out?
Yeah.
Oh, it is distressed,
it
isn't
is.
It? What have you got that down as?
Turkish.
Turkish.
Early 20th century.
There's decorators out there who like the shabby boho country house. That is going to make a room, okay?
This giant carpet is constructed from four woven panels stitched together and has been sourced from a large country estate. It's either Turkish or Afghan in origin, and likely to be wool.
How much can that be, then?
I could do it for £150.
Sold. I think it's really, really beautiful.
This is
lovely.
Nice.
Having already bagged some great pieces from Stacey and Alan, there are still two more dealers to visit, starting with Jack Holloway, who specialises in house clearances.
I do love a good house clearance place. We got any more of these?
There's a few knocking about.
Dairy bowls.
You can do that one at 50 quid.
Sold. Well, how much is the big one outside?
Larger one there. I'll tell you what, I'll do 50 on that too.
Sure.
Positive, yeah.
All right, we'll have both of those. A couple of dairy bowls on there, one particularly good one. We get the pair for 100 quid. We've met, some money's changed hands. You know, it's those connections. You want to be on people's radar. They want to be able to say, oh, yeah, I know him, he'll want that. Right, brilliant. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
On to the next one.
The final stop is a shop with a specialist mission. And it's the second time today that Drew will get early pickings.
Very much hunting, shooting and fishing themed.
Sitting and fishing. Right, OK.
And you're the first in, Drew. I've only opened the doors this morning.
You're kidding?
Wow. No, nope, absolutely
the
not.
First person in.
First person in.
We're the first two people in. And very smart it is too. There are some things in here straight away that I'm thinking, oh yes, look at that. I can find a home for that. Here we go again. I've just sold two of these. I've just sold a matched pair.
Three is always better than two.
How much are you asking for that one?
G. Kynock & Co. was a 19th century British Midlands munitions manufacturer, which became highly successful after supplying guns for the Boer War. Lavish mirrors such as this one were provided to retailers to promote sales of Kynock cartridges for hunting. Well preserved, this example could be worth around £1,500.
How much are you asking for that one?
Trade, I could do 1,100.
How's a grand grab you?
I'll meet you in the middle.
1,050?
Yeah.
Sold.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Just over £1,000. There's £300 to £400 profit left in it. Let's say it's worth about 1,500 quid-ish. And you've got all these traps underneath here, and something I really love, which are eel forks.
They look really nice, almost as architectural sort of display, because each region had different styles.
So you'd basically just trawl for your eels, wouldn't you? You'd just stick that in.
Yeah, absolutely. You'd be on the end of a long pole, and you'd spike them out of the mud, and they'd stick in through those tines there.
Eels have been a staple British food for many centuries. So important to society that at the time of the Doomsday Book, people in England owed more than 500,000 eels in taxes each year to their landlords.
Can we get them all out?
Yes, of course we can.
Are they all for sale?
Everything's for sale, Drew.
Righto. We're into folk art territory here because they were regional. There was lots of different styles, lots of different sizes, lots of different ages. So if you put those on your wall, it makes that room immediately feel like it's been there a very long time and there's been, you know, collectors bringing them in and that sort of thing's been in the family for years. And it embodies a brand new room with age. And basically, that's what we do. OK, that's what we're doing in our job.
I found a few more, Drew, you might be interested in.
OK. Those ones. Oh, that's the daddy. Look at that. Yeah, that's incredible. OK.
Absolutely. And some more.
So how much is this one?
Say 150.
150. And say if we're saying 50 quid each on each one of these.
Yeah.
So it's, what, how many's there now? 18, 19, 20, 21, 22.
22.
OK.
That's 1,100.
1,200 with this?
Yeah, I'm happy with that.
Yeah?
Yeah. Let's go for it.
First day of trading. Happy?
All got to be sold someday.
Not happy, easy, elated.
Oh, first day of Lee being open, we walk in and spend over 2,000 quid with him. I should imagine he's quite happy. But also, I will always call back in again because he's a guy who's buying good things. The good things are easy to sell.